Hi, good morning. Today we are going to discuss about the test cases preparation. The last session I explained about the test scenarios. So in this session, I'm going to explain to you what is test case design techniques, things to consider while writing test cases, types of test cases, what is positive and negative test cases. These are the concepts I am going to explain to you. Now it is a block diagram about the test case design. Now who is responsible for the test case design? Test engineers are the responsible. What are the inputs? Reference documents for the test engineer is requirement documents like BRS and FRS. Use case document, which is an optional. User interface design document. Then test scenarios. These are the different kind of inputs testing is going to refer before going to prepare the test cases. So in the previous sessions, I explained about the use case document, what it is, user interface design document, test scenarios. Today, in this session, my focus on about test case preparation. Okay. What is test case? Output of this phase is test case document. It describes validation procedure of a specific requirement in particular functionality or particular requirement in application, how to test, that is going to describe by the test case. But in order to prepare the test cases, what are the fundamental things we have to follow? The test cases should be simple and easy to understand. Naming convention should be followed. Test cases should have the high possibility to identify defects. There are no duplicate or redundant test cases. These are the basic things we have to follow. Then test case design techniques, which are nothing but black box testing techniques, like boundary value analysis, equivalence class partition, error gate. These are the major techniques which we are going to use. Apart from that, we have the other two also, decision table and state transition coverage. These two also is the optionally those we are going to use. Then types of test cases. So we derive in general three types of test cases, like user interface test cases, usability test cases, then functionality related test cases. Again, if I go for the functional related, we have the two things, positive test cases and negative test cases. These are the about this test case design phase. This thing more detailed way I'm going to explain now. What is test case? Test case describes validation procedure of a specific requirement in application. It describes validation procedure of a specific requirement in application. That means how to test particular requirement in application. Login functionality is there. How to test it is step by step going describes. A test case consists set of steps or sequence of steps with user actions to be performed. What type of operations we need to perform. So on application under test, and subsequent response from the system. Based on your operation, how application need to respond, that we are going to step by step. Like this. In Excel sheet, generally we are going to prepare. Basic components I'm giving here, step number. Right. Step description. Under this, we are going to write what type of operation to be performed under step description. Here I am going to write expected result. There is a subsequent response. Like this, multiple steps are going to have. Okay, like this. This is what the, in Excel sheet, step by step like this are going to write my. Test case consists set of steps or sequence of steps with user actions to be performed on AUT and subsequent response from the system. Who is responsible to prepare the test cases? test engineers. Testers are the responsible. Generally, after necessary training sessions, KT sessions, knowledge transfer sessions are completed, then test engineer is the responsible to derive the test cases for allocated module. When we are going to write the test cases, what are the basic things we have to consider? So keeping these points in mind, we are going to prepare the test cases. First thing, test cases should be simple and easy to understand. That means whatever test cases we are going to prepare, these test cases should be easy to understand other project members also. That is, the test case should be simple and easy to understand. Make sure there are no duplicate. Same test cases should not be repeated. There are no duplicate or redundant test cases. That means unnecessary test case also it should not be prepared. There are no duplicate or redundant test cases. Unnecessary test case also it should not be written. Whatever test cases you prepare, make sure the test case should have the high possibility to identify defects. So one thing you have to analyze when you are going to read the requirements, where developers may commit the mistakes while writing the programs. So in such a way, you have to think, you have to derive the test cases. Naming conventions should be followed. That means proper name we have to give for the test cases. That means, so TC, test case means test case one. Okay, then which project it is, which model related, then which functional related. Like this particular format we have to provide as per the company standards. Okay, that's the reason. So proper naming convention, BRS document I referred means don't write BRS. You can say that Gmail underscore BRS version 1.3, 1.2, like that we have to specify. So this is a naming convention should be followed. The next session, I'm going to explain to you how to prepare the formalized test cases in test case template. So how to give the naming convention, we are going to get an idea for that. Okay. These are the basic things you have to consider. So more, you need to understand the functionality flow. That is important. By reading the requirement documents, you need to keep these points in mind. Then you have to go for the test cases preparation. But which test case, unnecessary test case means best test cases we have to derive. How we can derive the best test cases? For that, we have to go for the test case design techniques. So to derive best possible test cases, that is the optimal test cases. And to achieve the completeness of testing, we use following black box testing techniques, which is also called as BBT or closed box testing also we are going to call. Earlier, I given the explanation about this black box testing techniques. So in the description of the recording session, this session, I'm going to provide that URL. Try to watch the about black box testing techniques. Without using any programming knowledge, validating application based on user specifications is called black box testing. Separate testing teams, we are going to use black box testing techniques to derive the test cases. Boundary value analysis, equivalence class partition, error guessing. Apart that, decision table or cause effect table, then state transition. These are the techniques which are going to use. Okay. About these techniques, detail way I explained the previous sessions. You can watch that one to get an idea. Next, types of test cases. As a functional test engineer, we derive three types of test cases. First one, user interface test cases. These test cases are derived to verify look and feel of the application, like availability of components, alignment of controls, font size, font style, clarity of image objects, control spelling correct or not, this type of things. To verify, if you derive the test cases, those are going to call user interface test cases. Second one, usability test cases. These test cases are derived to verify user friendliness of the application to perform operation. How easy to operate application, those factors to validate, such as error messages are meaningful or not, proper message displaying or not, tab implementation, user manuals are understandable or not, function keys implementation, this type of things where we are going to verify. Those kind of test cases we are going to call usability test cases. The third one is functionality test cases. These test cases are derived to verify application function behavior based on user operations. That means if you click on the link, how application responding? If I click on the push button, how application responding? So like the submit button is there. If I click, how it is responding like this. Usability, user interface, validation means only particular object validation purpose. If we derive the test case, that is called validation. So it comes under part of the functionality test cases. Okay. Validation means edit box is there. Only edit box purpose if I derive the test case. How, what type of characters allows, what is the size allows, or I have the drop down, expect values are there or not. Such test case we are going to call validation. But those also we can cover in the functionality test cases. Now here, there is a password encoder application. Previously I explained the scenarios for this application. Now here I have some test case I written to understand which one comes under what type of test case. I give one test case, verify availability of components in password encoder window. Availability of component, that is comes under user interface test case. Verify tab implementation, this is comes under usability test case. Test case three, verify password field allows customer expected size of string or not. That is comes under, then functionality working or not, we have to check the functionality test case. Verify generating encoded string. Functionality and generating or not, that is functional test case. Okay, verify copying encoded string, functionality test case. Verify closing password encoder application. This means these buttons are working or not, that is a functionality. Verify help functional, button is working or not, functionality. But verify user manuals are understandable or not, usability test case. So this is an example I given. So what type of test cases we are going to do? This is an informal way of writing the test cases. Formalized means in template we are going to write. But you to understand, so which one comes under usability related, which one comes under functionality, which one comes under user interface. For that I give this example. Okay. Then positive and negative test cases. What is the meaning of the positive and negative test cases? Based on validation and functionality, there can be two types of test cases. Positive test cases. What is the positive test cases? Test cases with primary flow or positive flow of events. Test cases with primary flow or positive flow of events. That we are going to call positive test cases. Same thing they may ask in interview, what is positive testing? Test with primary flow or positive flow of events. That means I want to write one test case to see is it successful login transaction or not. The output expectation successful transaction if you have, that is comes under positive test cases. Example, test case with valid inputs. Similar way, negative test cases. Test cases with alternative flow or negative flow of events. Test cases with alternative flow or negative flow of events. That means here expectation, some error message should pop up or unsuccessful transaction. These are expecting. Such a way you derive the test cases, those were going to call negative test cases. Example, test case with invalid inputs. Okay. So they may ask interview, what is positive testing, negative testing, or what is positive test cases, negative test cases. So understand me here, test with primary flow or positive flow of events. that is called positive testing. Test with alternative flow or negative flow of events, that is comes under negative testing or test cases we are going to see. Here I given some example. Test case one, verify account creation to valid data in all the mandatory and optional fields. That is positive test case. Verify account creation with valid data in all the mandatory and optional fields by missing any one of the optional field. Even though I miss the optional field, it will accept. So positive test case. Test case three, verify account creation with valid data in all the mandatory and optional fields by missing any one of the mandatory field. If mandatory field I am not entered, definite application is going to give the some error message. That is the reason it is negative test case. Verify account creation with valid data in all the mandatory and optional fields, whereas invalid data in any one of the optional field. So if I give the invalid data, even though it is an optional field, it should not accept. Blank will accept. Invalid data, it should not accept. That's the reason it is negative test case. Verify account creation with the different values in password and retype password fields. It should not accept. That is expectation, negative test case we are going to call. So there is a expectation when you have the successful transaction, positive. Expectation when we are saying that error messages, transaction will fail. Such way you derive the test case, that is comes under negative test cases. As a test engineer, we have to think both ways, positive way, negative way, so that you can able to derive the more effective test cases. Okay. So thank you. Subscribe my channel. So next session, I'm going to provide the how to write the test case in test case template. Bye.